Anyone charged with a criminal offence is innocent until proven guilty. But for professional athletes, it's often the other way round.
I do accept that some people will never believe me, but they are irrelevant to me because they don't know me. I can guarantee that if they actually got to know me and actually understood why I swim and why I wanted to represent my country, they would understand why I would never do this.
Shayna Jack has been a ferocious competitor for much of her life.
From about the age of 13 years old, my training was about 9 sessions a week. Each can range from 2 hours to 3 hours maximum. 3 gym sessions, and every now and then I'd have bike sessions or just fitness sessions.
So what sparked your interest in swimming?
I actually met Libby Trickett at a school function. And to meet her, for me, at that age was a big deal for me. She was so humble and so inspiring to me, and I looked at her and just thought, that's who I want to be. I want to be someone who can change someone's life in an instant just with a conversation. That's where I decided I wanted to become an Olympic swimmer.
And she was on her way to being one.
Six in a row and a world record.
How determined are you to add Olympic medals to this collection?
Very determined. You know, that dream's not gone. That dream will never disappear. I will keep fighting for it.
In late June, Shayna had a routine drug test during a training camp in Cairns. It was that test that threatened to cut short her career.
Then a couple of weeks later, you were in Japan preparing for the World Championships, and you got a phone call that turned your life upside down.
Sorry. I haven't really thought about that day since. It was very traumatic. You know, not only am I young, but it's something that is so far-fetched from what I'd ever think would happen to me. And when I got that phone call, my whole world did change. You're right.
Who called you?
I was actually shopping with one of the girls on the team in South Korea. And I got a phone call from one of the managers saying, you know, you need to come back to the hotel. And so I did run back because, you know, I don't want to miss my test. I never have missed a test. One of the managers met me and said, we've got to go up to the head coach's room. We got in there and he said to me, Asada has called me, but they couldn't tell him anything until I was present. And we called her back and she said the dreadful words of something prohibitive had been found in my sample.
Shayna's B sample was also tested, but it too showed traces of ligandrol, a substance similar to steroids that's designed to build and repair muscles.
I thought they were wrong. When they told me all this, I said, well, you've got to be wrong because I haven't bought this. I wouldn't buy this. I was told that it's not even found in Australia, that it has to be bought on the black market. And then, you know, the more you look into it and the more you speak to people about it, the more you find out that it's actually everywhere. And that
when you say it's everywhere, what do you mean by that?
I had a lot of people come forward and tell me that they take this drug. Just general people who go to the gym. Some people were using it as a recovery for, like, you know, they had big days at work but they wanted to exercise still, so they'd use it as a recovery. People informed me that they took it as a drop.
So you must have theories on how ligandrol could have possibly got into your system.
You know, there's chance of it being in a contaminated supplement. The only unfortunate thing is I actually hadn't taken supplements in 2 months prior to that test.
Nothing at all?
No.
No vitamins?
No. And I don't believe it was in my control either.
What do you mean?
There was a case in the past called the Kiss Cocaine case where someone had taken cocaine and then the partner, who was an athlete, kissed that person. And they were contaminated. And so I was being told that, you know, anything I'd come in contact with within that period could have been a risk of the contamination.
Shayna was ordered to return to Brisbane. No one knew why.
Swimming Australia sent you home but protected your right to stay silent until you chose to go public with the news. Was that the right way to go about it?
Yes.
Why?
I wasn't ready for the roller coaster that was yet to come in regards to media. But I also respected my team. They had a job to do. If they had found out about me, and we are a family, it's not easy for someone in your family to hear that you know, you're struggling and you are hurt.
The swimmer missed her opportunity to release the news. Her test results were leaked.
And I wasn't watching the news, actually. The only reason I knew was because someone had gone onto my Instagram and commented, you're a drug cheat and you should kill yourself.
Who did you turn to in that moment?
My partner, Joel, was the only one who was actually there at the time. I lost control of all my emotions, and I haven't had much control of my emotions since that day. There has been some nights that he doesn't know what to do because I'm just uncontrollable, a mess. And he recently, you know, recently I had one of those days, and the one thing he did was just bring my dog in. When I'm crying, he literally just puts his head on my shoulder, and he is big enough to do that. You know, my dog wouldn't judge me.
To make matters worse, her teammate Mac Horton had already used the World Championships to take a stand against doping.
During that national anthem, Horton did not stand up on the medal podium, and he's still not standing up. A silent protest, perhaps.
Did you support the stand that Mac took?
Mac made a decision in that time, and I respect the fact that he stood up for clean sport because I have always stood up for clean sport. Mac and I are teammates, and he is still family to me as he's a part of the swimming community, but we haven't spoken.
He received a lot of backlash from Chinese media. He received death threats. He obviously went through his own issues of that at that time. How did that make you feel when you heard that?
I didn't actually know in regards to how bad his backlash was. I was going through my own experience of, you know, social media criticism. I've never been bullied or harassed as much as I have been since that day.
I just wonder if you had any words about the Shayna Jack dispute.
Do you think it would help if you two could sit down and talk?
I would love to talk to him, but, you know, he's still preparing himself for Olympics next year, and I've got a completely different challenge ahead of me.
In a matter of weeks, Shayna went from being Australia's next golden girl to a disgraced drug cheat.
Shayna, are you still insisting your innocence, can we ask?
There's no comment to make at the moment.
I can't even step on pool deck without, you know, getting in trouble. I don't even know whether I can see my coach or not without getting in trouble.
You're banned from going to swimming pools when training is going on.
It means I can only swim after about 7 o'clock in the morning and before 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and during those times I'm studying and working.
The rules may keep Shayna away from the pool, but they haven't stopped her fellow Commonwealth Games gold medalists from supporting her fight.
Kate and Bronte were the people I go to. And from the beginning, they had my back.
She's never missed a doping test. Her whereabouts have always been up to date. So for something that is not her fault, and then the way that she was vilified was just despicable, and I feel incredibly sorry for her.
They've been supportive?
100%. They've gone out of their way to make sure that I'm okay. You know, whenever they come to town, they always see if I'm available to catch up and just chat and, you know, just talk and vent, and they do know who I am. They have trained with me, they've, you know, seen my love and passion for the sport and how much I just enjoy being part of the community.
That's a big call by them, because at this point you're known as a drug cheat. So for them to back you says a lot about them.
I think when you use the word drug cheat, the one thing that does pop into my mind is, can anyone define drug cheat? Have I taken drugs to enhance my ability in my sport? The answer is no.